Good morning, students. Hope you are safe. I am your environment teacher. Today, we are going to learn chapter number 13, A Shelter So High. Instructions. Watch the video carefully. After watching the video, write the exercise sent in PDF in your notebook. Let's begin. In this chapter, we are going to study about A Traveler's Tale, Cold Desert, At Home with Tashi, The Changpa, Houses of Srinagar and his return journey. Traveler's Tale. Here, Traveler's Tale is a story or a journey of Gaurav Jani and his motorcycle Loner. He named his motorcycle Loner. Here you can see in the picture Gaurav Jani with his motorcycle Loner. He liked to travel to different parts of India. Wonderful country. India is a wonderful country. Here in this lesson, he describes his amazing journey on the longest roads in India. He said, this journey took about 2 months. He had to carry everything on his motorcycle. And when we go for a journey, we carry all necessary things with us. In the same way, Gaurav Jani was on a journey on his motorcycle Loner. So he collected a small tent, sleeping bed, plastic sheet, warm clothes, food, camera, extra cans for petrol. Why do you think that he carried extra cans for petrol? Yes, on the way he must have passed through forest and lonely areas where no petrol pumps were seen. So he had to carry extra cans of petrol. Here in this picture you can see a tent and his motorcycle Loner. He started his journey from Mumbai, passed through small villages and towns of Maharashtra, Gujarat and Rajasthan, and he reached Delhi. He took 3 days to cover 1400 kilometers from Mumbai to Delhi. He found the houses of Delhi were similar to that of Mumbai. Then he started his journey further to the north and reached Manali in 2 days. He reached Manali in 2 days from Delhi to Manali. Okay. It was in mountains. He traveled through difficult roads of Jammu and Kashmir to reach Leh in Ladakh. Now he had to travel difficult roads, as we know that on mountainous regions the roads are very difficult to travel. You must have seen in Mount Abu and Pavagarh how the roads are. In the same way, in mountainous region, he had to travel to difficult roads of Jammu and Kashmir to reach Leh in Ladakh. Gaurav Jani and his Loner were covering long distances and needed food and tent to protect himself from cold at night. He had a tent and he just fitted in his nylon tent to sleep. Wherever they were tired, they stopped there and put a tent, and he fitted himself in the nylon tent. And his vehicle, his motorcycle Loner, had to stay outside the tent as a guard. In the morning, the breeze and the sound of birds woke him up. Now, when they reached Leh, it was a high, dry and flat area, and it was called cold desert. There were snow-capped mountains and a cold flat ground, as you can see in the picture. It had quiet street with beautiful white houses. So when he reached there, all the people, they started gathering him. And one of the person, Tashi, he took Gaurav to his home. Let's see how was the home of Tashi. Tashi's home was a building with two floors, do manjila. The house was made of stones which were kept one over the other. The walls were coated with thick layer of mud and lime. It looked like a shed from inside with a lot of hay stored there. It looked like a shed means it looked like a place where animals lived, because there was all grass and fodder that was stored for animals to eat. Okay, then there were wooden steps that led to the first floor where these people stayed. Dashi and his family stayed. The ground floor was for animals and for storing necessary things. If it was very cold, they moved to the ground floor, which had no windows, so that could be protected from cold. Thick trunks of trees were used to make the strong roof. Wood was used to make the roof of the house. The roofs were flat, where they dried red chilies, oranges, pumpkins, golden yellow corn, stacks of paddy, cow dung cakes, etc. Why do you think that they must have dried this thing? Because during winters there was heavy snowfall and people could not go out. So to store food for winter, in during summer season, they dried many fruits and vegetables and stored for winter season. The thick wall, the wooden floor and wooden ceiling protected them from cold. I hope you have understood the chapter. After watching the video, write the exercise in your notebook and mail it on following email ID. Thank you.